the wild wind. Hey, 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 hey. Ride the wild wind. Hey, gonna ride the wild wind. It ain't dangerous enough for me. Get your head down, baby. Yeah, we're gonna ride tonight.
Hello, my name is Don Gomo. I'm the president of the Empire State Motorcycle Safety Education Program. We're a not-for-profit organization that promotes motorcycle awareness and the benefits of rider education. But today, I'll be talking about Love Jugs Coolant Fans, which I'm happy to say is one of our sponsoring partners. I've been a fan of Love Jugs for almost six years now. I've had the original system on my bike. So what we're going to do today is kind of a garage tech video in a garage. The installation of these fans is very simple, and most of us would do it in our garage or our driveway, so I figured I'd do this approach. But I'll be installing the new Coolmaster fan with the Vibration Master kit on a 2007 CVO Ultra Harley-Davidson. As many of you know, the newer Harley-Davidsons do run hot. This is primarily because of EPA regulations that has a fuel ratio that's kind of lean, so the engines run hotter. And since this is a CVO model, it has a 110-inch motor, which obviously increases heat. Now, there's other ways that you can work on to reduce heat factors with your motor, engine work, upgrades of oil coolers, changing your ECM to adjust the fuel ratio, but I honestly believe the first step you should take would be installing a Love Jugs fans because they work so phenomenal. So what we have here, this is the original version. Like I said, about 5 or 6 years I've had this, runs great. I commute to New York City on a regular basis. So having these fans, I turn them on, I leave them on, and when temperatures are high in the city and you're dealing with stop and go traffic, I've never had an overheating problem. So what we're going to do today is we're going to be removing this setup, which is pretty much as if we're putting in a new thing because the difference would be the mounting of the horn. And we're going to be installing the new Coolmaster. As you can see, the Coolmaster is a little smaller in design, though it blows more air. The buttons have been redesigned for a sleeker look to it. And it's an all stainless steel construction, so it's definitely going to be holding up for the weather. And the fans are 100% waterproof. So what we're going to do is we're going to be replacing the existing stock or the existing system with the new Coolmaster upgrade. One of the first things we got to do is remove the seat. Typically, there's a fastener that holds the back of the seat, maybe a Phillips screw, maybe a thumb screw, but you remove that fastener. For those of you that have the stock seat, you have the passenger strap, you're going to have to remove that. So what we're going to do is we're going to get the seat removed right now. With the seat removed, we can find the accessory plug, which is located in front of the battery on this model. What you would need to do is check your owner's manual, because other models may have it in a different location or a different spot. They might be on your side covers. They might be in the same spot. But always check your owner's manual. You can see right now the existing fan has been plugged into the accessory. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove this so we can remove the wiring from the fan and start removing the old fan. All right, so we pulled the wire through that has the connector end on it. Most of the models do have a hole within the frame where you could snake the wire through. So what we're going to do is now remove this assembly by taking it off this fastener. Once we remove this, you got to remember just to disconnect your horn. There's two wires that are stake-on connectors, and we'll remove the horn. So once removed, you'll see the original dampening isolator here that is installed for the horn. We'll be removing that, as well as the two sets of bolts that we have here that go through the original mounting horn bracket we'll remove the horn, but we're going to be reusing this bracket. So probably the best way to remove this existing vibration dampening isolator is use a pair of round jawed vice grips. Get a good solid grip on it and you remove it by turning it counterclockwise. Don't worry about damaging the rubber on here because you're not going to be using this. If you're installing a Coolmaster fan or the original Love Jugs, you'll be removing this and replacing it with a different isolator, so don't worry about it. And since we are going to be installing this fan with the Vibration Master, we don't need this as well. So what we're going to do is we turn this and we start loosening it up and it will be removed. Once the isolator is removed, you'll see you have the female thread of a basically tapped or welded nut for your mount. And what we're going to do is go ahead and install the Vibration Master. So we'll be resecuring the horn onto the Love Jugs mounting bracket. And what you'll be doing is you'll be using the existing horn bracket. And you get the stainless steel insert that fits inside of here. And you bolt this all on. This is the two bolts where the horn goes through, and you secure that. This gives it an extra stiffness and it makes it more rigid as well. All right, so the horn and the bracket, everything's mounted back onto the cooling fan's mounting bracket. And at this point, what we're going to do is take a look at the Vibration Master installation. The installations are very easy to follow. There's a little bit as a suggestion of doing a little pre-assembly here by getting these dampening isolators in here mounted first. And once you get to that, you're going to wind up mounting the backing bracket with some more isolation. This Vibration Master is basically a heavier duty dampening system for your fans. And the install, following the instructions, it's very easy. You mount in the plate, and then you mount this to the plate, and you mount your bracket to the overall device. So we got the backing plate mounted with the quarter inch rubber isolator behind it. In most cases, I've been connecting things with blue Loctite, but for this instance, since it's going to be mounted to the frame and I'm not really going to be removing it, I've used some red Loctite for this bolt here. So now we're going to mount the rest of the vibration isolation system from the Vibration Master on. So with a half inch wrench, you tighten up the nuts that are behind. Once again, I use a little blue Loctite. And so now this is all secured. And now we're at a point where we're going to remount the horn and fan assembly. So we're all remounted. The only thing left for us to do is we got to take the wire. We'll snake it up along underneath the tank along the frame. We'll use some zip ties provided by Love Jugs. And we'll plug the plug back into the accessory switch. Okay, so we got everything mounted. We got the wiring secured. We made sure the wire is not touching any part of the head or the engine. We're plugged back in. So what we'll do is we'll turn the power on. Power is on, and then we'll turn on the fans individually. You can hear them starting up. It's an amazing amount of air that's being blown there. Now what we also can do is we can turn this fan system on and off from the accessory switch. So typically, I leave the fans running all the time and only turn them off if it's cool outside. By leaving them on all the time, you're already keeping your engine cooler. Why wait till the last minute if you feel heat? Then you're just blowing hot air across to your legs. So keep them on all the time. It will help keep it cool. So before we mount the seat, we're going to start it up and make sure everything okay. Okay, motor's running. As you can see, the mats are vibration. With a little bit of vibration, but that's at idle. Smooth out once you get rolling. So it did a pretty good job, far better than the original Elgato. So there you go, with about 30 minutes installation time, and that includes removing the old set of fans, which is not much different than removing the horn itself. You have a great looking product installed. Simple to do. Not only is it attractive looking, it will save your engine. Running the fans, keeping that motor cool is a big thing. Keeping the oil temperatures down, keeping the engine temperature down. You'll increase the life of your engine. You'll prevent overheating. Overheating can be a safety issue. That's the last thing you want to be, stop and go traffic, and then your bike just starts pinging and not wanting to run because it's overheating. This is a great system that will help keep you cool. So right now, we got the seat back installed. We're all wired. Nothing left to do but to go out for a ride. So I think that's what I'll do. So thank you for checking this out. Once again, check out Love Jugs at love-jugs.com, and you won't be disappointed. Tell them that we sent you from Empire State Motorcycle Safety Education Program. Have a great day.
A shining bright. I want to take your hand, lead you from this place. Don't leave it all.